both with an equal chance of getting through. I don't think I've met anybody who would really pull for one or other. They all think that it's going to be depend on who manages to play better in this next hour and a half or so.
And the lovely thing is we're going to see the contrast in styles between the baseliner, Martinez, and McNeil, who will like
first
to
set.
Get to the net.
This Conchita Martinez to serve. Thank you.
McNeil's intentions clear from the start.
Love 40.
She's Conchita doing well to make herself find a way to win this point. A good backhand there by Laurie, and prepared to try a touch volley early on.
That's the ideal start to make. Breaking serve in the opening game. Laurie McNeil, who of course won the grass court title up at Birmingham at Edgbaston just a few weeks ago, and she's won 4 titles on grass, her opponent none at all, so she has the track record.
Laurie McNeil is so at home on grass. She is an incredibly good mover, wonderfully swift athlete, and she stays very low to the ball, to the ground. So when she hits the ball, it stays low as well. Really, it's the way she plays, as well as her athleticism, that is good on grass. Her slice backhand is probably one of the best that there is
time
out there in the game. Her serve is good. And at the net, she's one of the very best, plus a very good anticipator of the ball. Although the first game doesn't, in the main thrust of things, mean all that much,
it's Laurie McNeil, so
it's very nice to get off to a good start.
Love 15. 15 on.
A little over ambitious. Chance was there, but really rolling the wrist over that forehand.
Both those two shots, the forehand before and that backhand, I think were really missed because she saw that Laurie had anticipated correctly.
Miss McNeil. Miss McNeil leads 2 games to love.
So easily, and now she's facing a different story. 4-3.
15-love.
Yes, I'm not surprised. She's annoyed with herself. So much time, and in the end, choosing the wrong option, trying the clever shot rather than the easy one.
Thank you. deuce.
I think he would have been a winner anyway, despite the slip.
Although Laurie is such a great athlete, she does tend to quite often slip on the court, even on playing on hard surfaces. To begin with, Conchita reacted very well and put up some lobs, but she ran out of options in the end. There wasn't very much she could do with that shot.
Look at the difference for both players, the percentage of points they win behind their first serves and their second. Extraordinary difference.
How many returns has she managed to get down at Laurie's feet? Quite a lot, and she'll start to get more if she plays better. Then Laurie has to volley up, and she's got a second chance. She's jumping quite a lot on her shots, but that was a great backhand.
Deuce. Advantage, Miss Martinez.
Second double fault from Laurie McNeil, giving her opponent a second point to level at 4-all.
Forehand volley is paying dividends for Laurie. Another just perfect one. Full stretch, she keeps her balance so well, and it just sped off the ground. Conchita was there, but without a chance to play.
Advantage, Miss McNeil.
Maintaining the attack on the Martinez backhand and putting away the high volley very comfortably indeed.
That's up.
That's a good shot. Yes. Deuce for the fifth time.
Correction, planet.
Well, in the first 35 minutes of the match, we've certainly had plenty of incident of the line calls. This time an overrule from Wayne McEwen. Did it instantly, which is what the umpire has to do. So we replayed the point. It's deuce.
Advantage, Miss Martinez.
If I was in Laurie McNeil's camp, I'd be a little worried when she starts staying back and gets herself involved in baseline rallies. That's playing her opponent's game.
Deuce.
Well, it helps when she gets her first serve in, David. She's started to get a little bit edgy on her first serve.
Advantage, Miss Martinez.
This eighth game of the match has now lasted 11 and a half minutes, and here's a fourth break point. Anticipating well, going to cover most of the down the line shots.
She's been almost right with her guess every time. Tactic from Laurie to make sure she came in on the second ball. She's having some problems with Conchita's return.
That's off.
Decisive.
McNeil leads 5-3.
So a game lasting 12 and a half minutes, and McNeil now one game away from taking this first set. It's 3-5.
Love 15.
Very confident play by Laurie. Look at the way her feet move so well. You couldn't tell which way she was going to hit this. And again, she closes in very nicely, very confident overhead.
Help. Love 40.
Three set points. Just one set point remains. A terrific contrast between the forehand drives of these two players. Martinez whipping it up with heavy topspin. Her opponent much flatter. Well played.
A good point by Conchita, very dedicated, gutsing it out there and making herself come in and actually showing a truly great backhand volley. Good pickup from Love 40.
Advantage, Ms. Martinez.
Once again, the anticipation uncanny. Line pass. Martinez is just going to have to vary those a little bit more.
Advantage, Miss Martinez.
little bit lazy on that last shot, Martinez. Been wrong-footed and stretched for the ball with the arm rather than moving the feet.
Reacting so much quicker at this stage of the match.
Martinez.
A good pickup, very good hands on that, and then having to handle quite a tough volley right there.
Deuce.
Seven deuces in the last game. This is the fourth of this one.
Wait, please.
He doesn't quite get this
Martinez.
Slice return deep enough, but still Conchita managed to actually get right under very low ball and handle that very well.
Two double faults from both players.
Advantage, Mr. McNeil.
Set point for the fourth time.
Game, first set, Ms. McNeil, 6-3.